Teaching religion to children is as bad as child abuse. Hundreds of kids die every year for unnecessary circumcision. If circumcision is killing more children than it's saving, then maybe it's time to make it illegal. According to World Health Organization, circumcision reduces pleasure, and that pleasure is more beneficial than any benefit from circumcision. People think abortion is a bad thing, but the problem is that lack of abortion leaves women in poverty, as told by The Guardian. People who are unfit to be parents should not be allowed to have kids. We need a license for cars and guns, but not to raise the most dangerous animals in the world called humans. Bad parents create evil humans, so it's best for only good humans to have children. We should be taking care of the starving and orphans instead anyways. Breeding humans and adding to overpopulation only kills the starving humans. 14 commandments on how to be a good parent. 1. Thou shall be rich before having kids. 2. Thou shall replace bad habits with good. 3. Thou shall not yell or hit kids. 4. Thou shall not argue around kids. 5. Thou shall not be over-controlling. 6. Thou shall feast on vegan whole foods. 7. Thou shall not force religion. 8. Thou shall not send kids to public schools. 9. Thou shall not give kids homework. 10. Thou shall stop bullying. 11. Thou shall keep media educational. 12. Thou shall keep index funds for kids' future. 13. Thou shall teach kids investing. 14. Thou shall not modify kids' bodies. The solution to school. Parents think schools are one of the best places for children. The exact opposite is true. According to CNN, CNBC, Harvard, Times, CBS, NBC, and USC, schools are more dangerous than cigarettes. Schools are more dangerous than cigarettes because of the location, all the sitting, the junk food, bullies, predators, and school shooters. Sitting has been shown to be more dangerous than cigarettes, and school is like 8 hours of smoking cigarettes. Kids mostly sit in their dangerous desks all day. Not to mention that 1 out of 3 schools are in danger zones, according to Al Jazeera. The good news is that a few rare schools allow the children to learn while standing. The best thing to do is homeschool children. Children who are homeschooled are 40% less likely to die from child abuse. Public schools are a waste of tax money. Kids can learn way more online. The key is to make sure the gadgets kids use can also access educational content. A parent can put a lock on all the other apps. There are so many educational games that kids can learn from. That's the proper way to use gadgets. Homeschooling almost costs nothing for taxpayers and can save the government a lot of money. A free, online, fun, and educational system is the best way to educate the masses of real and practical information. A lot of the subjects in schools are pointless. Investing is more important than any subject in school. NPR showed that 77% of students witness bullying. 87% of school shooters were bullied. According to Stanford, 87% of students are sleep deprived because of school. Being bullied and sleep deprived will only make it more likely for school shootings. Homework is a waste of time and child abuse, as shown by studies presented by Salon. Homework makes children sick, as told by Daily Mail. Sexual harassment is another issue, with some schools with rates of 80%. The foods in school are also not good for children. The meat and dairy industry spends more than $100 million bribing Congress and the education system to keep its dangerous products in schools. A study presented by CNN showed that meditation is more effective than detention for disciplining children. cure for the poor. There are about 1 billion starving humans and about 2 billion that live under $3. The best way to cure homelessness and poverty is by having the government give every citizen an unconditional living wage. People think this will cause inflation and things to become more expensive. That's a slippery slope fallacy and not true. The reality of the situation is that universal basic income, which is a regular, livable, unconditional wage paid to every human, will speed the economy up by $2.5 trillion. This is proven by Vox, CNBC, and MSN. The reason universal basic income will grow the economy is because there are a lot of vacant homes that can be filled, which means more money to the rich, and more tax money to the government. Since there won't be poor people anymore, crime rate will fall like a rock. Multiple studies also show that universal basic income doesn't make people lazy like welfare. People don't need welfare or food stamps or a minimum wage if they're paid a living wage to begin with. The one reason people are poor and have to work their whole lives just to survive is because their parents decided to have them when the parent was poor. Rich parents are more likely not to raise struggling kids. The struggle leads a lot of people to steal. That's why giving kids a consistent allowance lowers crime rate. There's many things being thrown out from stores after a while because people don't buy them or won't have the money to buy them. Universal basic income will encourage more spending. According to Huffington Post, universal basic income helps with school, health, and the community. A study conducted by CNN showed that giving cash to criminals stops crime. It's like bribing criminals to not commit crimes anymore. The reality is that the money helps the criminals turn their life around. Even in the country Iran, universal basic income encouraged people to work more, expand their businesses, and work towards more meaningful lines of work. The one thing all religions have in common. I've heard many times from religious people that God said it was okay to kill and eat animals. I find this phrase quite interesting because every religion I have looked into clearly tells people not to eat meat and dairy. There are way more religious texts against the idea of eating meat and dairy. Maybe it was okay to eat meat and dairy in the past, but times have changed. We don't need to eat meat or dairy to survive anymore. We have plenty of vegan alternatives in every country, and every part of the world. Beans, rice, grains, pasta, and starches are some of the cheapest foods known to humans. The one thing that all religions have in common is that they're against the killing of innocent animals who don't need to die for an unnecessary reason like taste pleasure. Below will be verses from different religions all telling people not to eat meat and dairy. First, let's start with the biggest religion of them all, Christianity. All Christians, and Catholics and any follower of Jesus is a believer in the Bible. The Bible clearly tells humans not to eat meat and dairy. One verse of the Bible says you save humans and animals alike, O Lord. Killing animals and eating them is not saving them. God and Jesus clearly tells us to save animals instead of eating and killing them. Another verse from the Bible says the wolf and the lamb shall feed together, the lion shall eat straw like an ox, but the serpent, its food shall be dust. They shall not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain. God and Jesus suggests that all animals will eat plants, even the lions. God promises to destroy all meat eaters. God refers to disobeying meat eaters as serpents. Serpents are people who eat meat and kill animals. God promises us a vegan world where no one will hurt or destroy on his holy mountain. The verse where God promises us a vegan world is told as unto every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. God provided plants and mushrooms, and algae for all animals to eat. God does not want animals killing each other, including humans. That is savagery and barbaric, and God calls them serpents. Jesus promises us a vegan world when he said the wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The wolves and leopards will live in peace with humans and other herbivores. The second largest religion is Islam. Islam gets a lot of hate from the media, and Muslims are some of the biggest meat eaters on the planet. Muslims believe in an idea called halal killing, which is similar to America's idea of humane killing. The problem is there's no good way to kill an animal. The way Muslims kill the animals is the most barbaric, because they don't let the animal sleep before being killed. Muslims think that Allah said it was okay to kill animals, when in fact, Allah said the exact opposite. In the Quran, Allah says animals form communities like you. If animals form communities like humans, then surely they deserve moral consideration. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said many times not to kill or eat animals. One saying from Muhammad is, do not allow your stomachs to become graveyards. People let their stomachs become a graveyard for the animals, which is the exact opposite of what Muhammad told people to do. Muslims aren't even following their prophet's orders. Muhammad also stated that he who takes pity, even, on a chicken and spares its life, Allah will be merciful on him on the Day of Judgment. Muhammad required us to be compassionate, even to chickens, because all animals are living beings. Our compassion towards animals is practice for showing compassion to other humans. I see Muslims killing animals all the time, even though their prophet clearly said, Allah will not give mercy to anyone, except those who give mercy to other animals. It is very rare when a Muslim gives mercy to an animal, instead of killing or eating them. Prophet Muhammad also said, fear God in your treatment of animals. I think most Muslims should be scared and shivering from all the fear, with what Prophet Muhammad said. Muhammad also said all animals are like a family of God, and he loves the most those who are the most beneficent to his family. My question to Muslims is, how are you helping God's animals? How are you helping God's family? Killing God's animals is not helping God's family. It's no wonder most Muslims are doing poorly because of God's wrath. The people asked, O Allah's Apostle, is there a reward for us in serving animals? Muhammad replied, yes, there is a reward for serving every animal. It looks like Muslims need to focus their priorities in serving animals, instead of killing and eating them. The messenger says, whoever is kind to the animals of God is kind to himself. The prophet was asked if acts of charity even to the animals were rewarded by God. He replied, yes, there is a reward for acts of charity to every animal alive. Muhammad said the best way to get into heaven is by helping animals in his verse. Kindness to animals was promised by rewards in life hereafter. Allah also says in the Quran in one verse that anyone who spreads environmental destruction should be killed. Animal farming is the number one cause of environmental destruction. The best way not to destroy the land is by giving up meat and dairy. Buddha told all his followers not to eat meat or dairy. The Dalai Lama still eats meat despite Buddha's teachings. This is probably why China calls the Dalai Lama the wolf in sheep's clothing. Below is all the verses of Buddha's teachings not to eat meat or dairy. If a person does not harm any living being, and does not kill or cause others to kill, that person is a true spiritual practitioner. All beings tremble before danger, all fear death. When a man considers this, he does not kill or cause to kill. All beings fear before danger, life is dear to all. When a man considers this, he does not kill or cause to kill. Whosoever tries to find happiness through hurting other beings, will not find happiness. One who, while himself seeking happiness, oppresses with violence other beings who also desire happiness, will not attain happiness hereafter. One who, while himself seeking happiness, does not oppress with violence other beings who also desire happiness, will find happiness hereafter. To avoid terror to living beings, let the disciple refrain from eating meat. The food of the wise is that which is consumed by the sadhus holy men, it does not consist of meat. There may be some foolish people in the future that will say that I permitted meat eating and partook of meat myself, but meat eating I have not permitted to anyone, I do not permit. I will not permit meat eating in any form, in any manner or in any place, it is unconditionally prohibited for all. He who, seeking his own happiness, punishes or kills beings who also long for happiness, will not find happiness after death. Thus, Mahatma, meat eating I have not permitted to anyone, I do not permit, I will not permit. The eating of meat extinguishes the seed of great compassion. If a man can control his body and mind and thereby refrains from eating animal flesh and wearing animal products, I say he will really be liberated. As a mother even with own life protects her only child, so should one cultivate immeasurable loving kindness towards all living beings. He who both day and night takes delight in harmlessness sharing love with all that live, finds enmity with none. Hinduism is a big religion that is against eating meat. Because animals are considered sacred in Hinduism, Buddhism, and Jainism, it can be considered a hate crime to kill or eat animals the same way it's a hate crime to burn a flag or holy book, or saying offensive words. Killing animals is worse than words or burning a book or flag. One verse from the holy Hindu scriptures says, "By not killing any living being, one becomes fit for salvation." The Hindu religion also requires the death sentence for anyone who kills animals. One who partakes of human flesh, the flesh of a horse or of another animal, and deprives others of milk by slaughtering cows, O king, if such a fiend does not desist by other means, then you should not hesitate to cut off his head. The Hindu god will also express his wrath and fire on those who eat meat by saying, those who are meat eaters have to face Agni, the god of fire's wrath. The Hindu religion wants to see all species as the same, and as equal. This is something that all religions have in common. Even the Quran talks about how we all form communities, and the Bible talks about how we all will live on God's holy mountain together. Meat can never be obtained without injury to living creatures, and injury to sentient beings is detrimental to the attainment of heavenly bliss, let him therefore shun the use of meat. Having well considered the disgusting origin of flesh and the cruelty of fettering and slaying corporeal beings, let him entirely abstain from eating flesh. Judaism also states in the scriptures, "Do not eat meat from killed animals." This includes animals that were killed by humans, yet most Jewish people eat meat despite their religion. However, Israel has one of the biggest vegan populations because Jewish people understand what oppression is like, especially since gas chambers still exist, and are being used by animals. The way humans treat animals is practice on how they treat each other. A program called New Start put prisoners on a vegan diet, and return to prison rate dropped by 87%. Logical fallacies. People always make up excuses for eating meat and dairy. It's understandable since meat and dairy triggers parts of the brain similar to cocaine and heroin. Meat has a chemical called uric acid and hypoxanthine that triggers the brain like cocaine. It makes people want more and more, it's addicting. Cheese has a chemical called casimorphins that makes it hard for people to stop eating it. I used to make plenty of excuses myself. Every excuse people make for eating meat and dairy have been debunked by logical fallacies. A logical fallacy is a type of flaw in a person's reasoning. Here are all the reasons people use and the logical flaw they are making. Logical fallacies, types of flaws in a person's reason. But lions, bears, wolves, sharks eat meat. Appeal to nature fallacy. Just because something is natural, doesn't mean it's good. Two-quoke fallacy. Just because others do harm, doesn't make it okay for you to do harm. False equivalence fallacy. Animals do it for survival. Humans have other choices. Bandwagon fallacy. Just because others are doing it, doesn't make it okay for you to do it. Food chain circle of life. Appeal to nature fallacy. Just because something is natural, doesn't mean it's good. It's part of tradition. Appeal to tradition fallacy. Just because it's part of a tradition, doesn't make it good. I like the taste. It's tasty. Irrelevant conclusion fallacy. Just because you like the taste, doesn't make it good. What about bugs and insects? Moving the goalpost fallacy. Bugs and insects are animals too. I eat it for survival. False dilemma fallacy. It's not for survival when you have other choices. Beans, rice, nuts, seeds, mushrooms, fruits, vegetables, grains, pasta, starches. It's my choice. Irrelevant conclusion fallacy. Just because you have the choice, doesn't make it good. Your choice is causing the killing of animals. They would kill you if they could. Hypothesis contrary to fact. This fallacy consists of offering a poorly supported claim about what might have happened in the past or future if circumstances or conditions were other than they actually were or are. The fallacy also involves treating hypothetical situations as if they were fact. But we are omnivores. Appeal to nature fallacy. Just because something is natural, doesn't mean it's good. It's my job. What about farmers? Appeal to emotion fallacy. Just because it's a job, doesn't make it good. One person can't make a difference. Appeal to consequence fallacy. Every person makes a difference. God said it's okay. Appeal to authority fallacy. Just because God said it's okay to eat meat in the past for survival reasons, doesn't make it okay to eat today when we have other choices. Animals will overpopulate. False cause fallacy. Humans are the ones that are forcing them to populate. They jack off the male bulls, then shove it up the butt of a cow, bestiality and rape. Baby cows are kidnapped from the mother and killed on day one if it's a boy because they can't produce milk or eggs. As soon as they can't produce any more milk, they are murdered less than half a full life. Humans are smarter, more important, and more powerful. Survival of the fittest. Genetic fallacy. Just because the genes are different, doesn't give the right to slavery. Veganism is too expensive. False dilemma fallacy. Rice, beans, grains, pasta, and starches are much cheaper than meat and dairy. What if it was humane, whole, kosher, free-range, cage-free, grass-fed? Moving the goalpost fallacy. Killing is wrong no matter how you do it. Why is it wrong? Because they feel pain just like humans. Because it's bad for the environment and for humans. Because of empathy. What would happen to all the animals? Moving the goalpost fallacy, gradually put them in a sanctuaries with a meat and dairy / carbon tax. But you and vegans kill when they drive cars. False equivalence fallacy. More animals are killed because of meat and dairy eaters. I don't care and I'm too lazy. Appeal to irrelevant conclusion fallacy. Just because you don't care, doesn't make it okay. It was already dead. False cause fallacy. You are paying them to kill it for you like a hitman. I have my beliefs, you have yours. False equivalence fallacy. Your beliefs are causing animals to die. Animals are dying for your beliefs. You're just more compassionate and sensitive than me. Irrelevant conclusion fallacy. Just because I'm more compassionate or sensitive, doesn't mean it's okay for you to pay for killing. I'll eat less meat. Middle ground fallacy. Just because you eat less meat doesn't make it okay. But other humans will always kill and eat meat. Bandwagon fallacy. Just because others do it, doesn't make it okay for you to do it. Two-quoke fallacy. Just because others do harm, doesn't make it okay for you to cause harm. They were going to die anyways. Irrelevant conclusion fallacy. Just because we are going to die, doesn't make it okay to kill. Meat is necessary. False dilemma fallacy. Vegan diet has all nutrients and vegans live longer on average. What about backyard chickens? Moving the goalpost fallacy. Backyard chickens are almost always factory farmed. The males are killed first day of being alive since they can't produce eggs. Once the chicken can't produce any more eggs, it's killed. Stealing eggs from chickens also encourages them to make more eggs to fill their nest. This is very hard on their body. Without the stolen eggs to eat, they won't be able to replenish their own lost nutrients. 97% of all chickens are factory farmed according to Huffington Post. What about honey? Moving the goalpost fallacy. The beekeepers chop off the wings of a queen bee to keep them trapped, then they steal all of its honey and replaces it with fructose corn syrup. If humans went extinct, every other species would benefit from it. If bees went extinct, the whole system collapses. Why are vegans so skinny? Ad hominem fallacy. Attacking vegans to discredit their claims and stereotyping a whole diverse group of people. But meat grew our brains. False cause fallacy. It was starchy carbs that grew human brains according to Sydney University, Huffington Post, Daily Mail, and Market Watch. Starchy carbs that grew human brains according to Sydney University, Huffington Post, Daily Mail, and Market Watch. Stop shoving your beliefs down our throats. Faulty comparison fallacy. You're shoving your beliefs down the throat of animals. Animals are being killed for your beliefs. Most species eat meat. Burden of proof fallacy. 75% of species don't eat meat according to Fact Monster. Provides other excuses or opposing view. Ad hoc fallacy. When someone holds on to certain beliefs, despite any evidence presented to the contrary. As a result, they begin to make up excuses as to why their belief could still be true, and is still true, despite the fact that they have less evidence for what they are making up. Cognitive bias fallacy. To favor weaker evidence over stronger evidence because it go against a person's pre-existing beliefs. Cognitive dissonance fallacy is the mental discomfort experienced by a person who simultaneously holds two or more contradictory beliefs, ideas, or values. The biggest excuse I had before going vegan was that plants feel pain too. The reason this argument doesn't work is because more plants are killed because people eat meat. Farming animals uses up more plants than if we ate the plants directly and if we stopped breeding these animals. According to New York Times, 91% of Amazon destruction is because of animal farming. They chop the trees down then use that land to breed animals. According to the United Nations, 82% of starving children live in countries where the grains are fed to farmed animals, and the farmed animals are eaten by Western countries. Going vegan can cure global warming since animal farming is the biggest cause of climate change, according to the United Nations Newsroom report. How to live longer and be happier. The good habits to build to be healthy is eating green vegetables, beans, nuts, seeds, legumes, B12 supplement, vitamin D3 supplement, red cloves, ulma, and astaxanthin for its antioxidants. Another good habit to build is drinking enough water. Being in a power pose, while smiling, and meditating the things a person is thankful for, can have strong and positive effect on health. Getting enough rest is also essential to be healthy. Some people need 7 hours of sleep while others need 9. This depends on age, and other factors. Generally, sleeping in for 7 to 9 hours should be good for most healthy people. Upbeat music can not only make a person exercise better, but it can also improve their mood. Humans should work out at most 7 hours a week. Studies show that napping is also healthy for humans. 6 pillars of investing. Every human should be investing. Investing in themselves and investing in assets. Assets are possessions that make a person money whether they work or not. This book is an asset. Investing and assets are the key in getting rich. There are 6 pillars of investing that a human needs to be a billionaire. The first pillar of investing is getting money. There are many ways to get money. Some people get money as handouts while others provide a service or product for money. The more money a person makes, the better for their investments. The faster a person makes money, the better for their investments. The second pillar of investing is budgeting. Most people get their hands on money and then lose it right after. Some people store their money in banks where it's losing value as products and services become more expensive. The reason money loses its value over time is because the government keeps printing more money, which makes it less valuable. What a person should do instead is buy only the necessary things and invest the rest of the money. Most things people buy are not necessary, and usually people can find better deals on the types of products they buy. The third pillar is building good credit. Having good credit is backup for when a person needs to borrow large amounts of money for a great deal. Good credit can come in handy for a stock market crash. When the market crashes, a person can use their good credit to buy a cheap house to rent out or cheap stocks. Not only will they be able to pay off their cheap interest loan, but they will be able to capitalize on the opportunity. The fourth pillar of investing is investing in assets. One of the best assets people can buy are stocks and bonds. The best stocks to buy are usually low-risk growth stocks that have been growing 35% the past year and at least 200% the past 5 years. I would never buy a stock that has its lowest price below $3. Stocks that fall below $3 are not worth the risk. The fifth pillar in investing is diversifying. A person should spread out their money as much as possible. For example, I own over 400 stocks, short-term government bonds, and index funds. That way, if a few crash, I still have the others making me money. Sometimes they all will crash, but that's just a good opportunity to buy stocks on discount. The final pillar to investing is rebalancing. It's always a good idea to keep up to date on the latest news. Some stocks might become overvalued, which will mean it's time to sell. The biggest key to investing is buying low and selling high. Most people buy when the stock is at its peak, and then they panic sell when the stock falls. People should buy more as it falls, and sell more as it rises. Good stocks have debt less than 70% and have positive earnings per share and positive P/E ratio. The earnings per share should be more than the dividends per share. Sell a stock as it becomes more risky and starts having less volume. The stock market always moves up and down like a roller coaster. When stocks fall 10%, that's a correction and a person should buy at this dip before bouncing back up. When stocks fall 20%, they call that a deep correction and it's still a good time to buy more at the dip. When stocks fall 30%, it can be hitting a bear market, so people should hold until it drops further. When a stock falls 40%, we call that a crash and it's best to sell bonds and buy more stocks on discounted prices. Cash is good to have to buy the dips. Bonds is safer than stocks and index funds, but also grows slower. Sometimes it's best to sell bonds to buy dips in stocks. Index funds are less risky than stocks since they include many companies in one, but stocks has potential of growing the fastest. High yield dividend stocks and index funds are good to collect because they pay the keeper for holding onto them. With enough dividends, a person can retire and live off of it. Everyone should create their own investing style that fits their circumstances and risk tolerance. Some of the best ways to invest is through the apps Robinhood and M1 Finance. Sign up with these links to receive a free stock and free $10. www.share.robinhood.com web link. www.mzy.co web link. Land of the greed, home of the slave. America has a serious prison problem built on slavery and punishment. America has more prisoners than every other country in the world. Instead, the prison system should be based on rehabilitation, deterrence, amends, and fairness. The reason some European countries are so well with their prison population is because they don't believe in punishment. There are drugs like magic mushrooms and LSD that permanently change the brain's chemistry. Some of these drugs might be able to cure criminal behavior. One big deterrence that should be included in prisons is the ban of meat and dairy. If meat and dairy were not in prisons, then people will be more careful of their actions because of how addicted they are to meat and dairy. What are we teaching murderers by killing animals and feeding it to them? A program called New Start put prisoners on a vegan diet and return to prison rate dropped by 87%. Meditation for prisoners also reduced violence according to NPR, BBC, and CNN. It is also a good idea to give prisoners a chance to make amends to those they hurt. Marijuana is racist. A lot of countries lock people up in prison for marijuana. Some countries will kill a person for marijuana. What people don't seem to realize is that smoking weed is good for the lungs, according to Harvard. Harvard also says that weed improves brain function. One Canadian university stated that weed increases brain cells. New York Daily News and Science Mag both found that pot increases intelligence in teens. Another study by Elite Daily showed that studying high will make a person get high grades. One anti-weed agency admitted that weed makes humans live longer, according to the Rastafarian study in Jamaica. Weed makes people live longer by 2 years. Weed also makes alcoholics and cigar users to live longer. According to studies demonstrated by Huffington Post and The Guardian, weed increases peace and lowers violence. Studies presented by USA Today stated that weed lowers crime and builds new schools. Studies also show that pot smokers are happier and more successful. USA Today showed another study that weed makes people drive safer. Auto insurance companies also have statistics that show that stoners are safer drivers than sober drivers. Fox News admitted that traffic deaths fell after weed became legal. The DMV admitted that phones are more dangerous than weed. Multiple studies from CNN, Russia Times, and Stanford showed that weed increases a person's sex life. Being against weed is also racist since it's part of many ethnic cultures, and the Nixon administration admitted they made weed illegal to make it easier to arrest blacks and Mexicans. The reason they called weed marijuana was to make it sound more Mexican and dangerous. Cannabis is one of the best medicines for sleeping, pain, eating, depression, and anxiety. Meat and dairy is more dangerous than weed. No one has ever died from weed, but billions die from meat and dairy. Justice is the most important thing in the world to me. Justice is everything. Injustice needs to be confronted, challenged, and deleted. Justice requires action. This is my solution, my gift to humanity. We can do this together. Spread this message.